20 years ago, the MSF team in Kigali saw the town descend into violence. These were the first days of what would go on to become known as genocide. The team tried to help the victims, but were quickly overwhelmed by the task. On the 13th of April, an MSF surgical team working in partnership with the International Committee of the Red Cross arrived to relieve them.
We decided to work together and set up a field hospital. As we went through militia checkpoints, we would be told there was no point in us doing what we were doing, as they were planning to kill all the Tutsis anyway. In reality, it was impossible to transport adult males.
MSF carried on working in many parts of the country for months. The organization's humanitarian principles were often violated by the perpetrators of the genocide, who had no hesitation in pursuing their murderous onslaughts inside medical facilities, targeting patients and health workers.
Humanitarian aid was regularly diverted for criminal purposes, for killing people. It was patently obvious during the genocide. Safe havens became slaughterhouses, and hospitals and churches where people would expect shelter and protection were, quite the contrary, the first places where they would be executed.
20 years on, the teams are still deeply affected by the events they witnessed in Rwanda.
We lost at least 200 Rwandan colleagues just during the genocide. They were murdered. We were so aghast at the sheer size of what was happening, how extreme it all was, that we, as an organization, didn't always do what we should have done to help our colleagues get away.
The medical teams found themselves constantly in the face of horror when they realized that the killings were in fact the premeditated extermination of a whole group of people. They perceived the limits of humanitarian action more clearly than ever before. For the one and only time in its history, MSF made a public demand for armed intervention, pointing out a very simple truth: doctors can't stop genocide.